your first interest in photography? What was the trigger to start having a maybe more involved in photography, and what is the trigger?
Trigger? Yeah, well, I was I became interested in photography when I was quite young, and really used it as an excuse to avoid everything else that I should be responsible for. Opportunity came to get involved in a photography class, and my mother gave me her Voigtlander camera, and you know, I started from that. Gave me an opportunity to start poking my nose into other people's lives and experiencing a little bit of travel. And you know, I intended to go into something like illustration, but kept putting that off. You could say that I just my interest in life, people. So photography gave me an opportunity to explore that. I think, like a lot of people, especially a lot of young photographers that I hear from today, quite frequently they ask me. They say they've been traveling, and how do they make a profession out of photography? Started that way. I just kept looking for some, the next opportunity to travel and photograph. And fortunately for me, I was able to focus the effort, refine it, and create a niche for myself, for my work. And through that way, I was able to then kind of find some way to apply that to a profession.
And working in National Geographic, can you explain us in a few sentences what it's like, and how much do you have to travel from 365 days, for example, which is the percent of traveling because of National Geographic and something?
Well, it's working for National Geographic, of course, it's a great responsibility. It's also a great honor. Especially these days, budgets, a lot of publications, exchanging with the internet and everything. But National Geographic is quite special. It has a long history of funding projects of social significance and the environment and the world that we live in. So it's quite an honor to be a part of that. So, of course, the pressure's on. Succeed in that way, but you have to really try to, or I try to, not let that influence what I do. Once you get out there in the field, you really kind of forget about that, because you get so wrapped up in the subject and somewhat obsessed with what you're doing, understanding it. Start out making a budget, and, not just the expense budget, but the time budget, and then how you're going to make the photographic effort, which direction, what to leave in, what to leave out of any story, a narrative.
also helpful because then I can step back and look at the project and progress. And, you know, it's important. I mean, I'm the kind of person, the kind of photographer that after a few weeks, you kind of start to get a little bit numb. Maybe you have to kind of step back. Positive, I think, to have a photo of like Apollo, because you made a family, a photography family, and you know, rely on each other to have some feedback on your work. I think that's really important. That's an advantage with National Geographic. The editors that I have, and the other photographers, so it's like a family. So that's something I've experienced coming here and seeing how Apollo Club and the Photorama, it's a very nice thing that you have a photo family. So it's really, I respect that.
What do you think about the whole festival and what will you bring home? Just memory from the summer. Something because you are traveling a lot, so maybe what is that memory which you remember for, I don't know, a few years or something?
Well, I think the one thing that really strikes me is the friendliness and openness of the people. You know, it's been very nice, you know, I feel very welcome, and just the people seem like they're very close to life. Essentials of life, and what you see, the way people are, life in the streets, and so on. It's not every place that has that. I mean, a lot of places, either it's too urban, and everybody's caught up in their day-to-day careers, no time for friends, and it seems like a very nice balance. Of course, there is always the need to develop a stronger economy, and we think that we need more economic strength in our lives, but let's not forget about those simple things. And, you know, I think that's something that I'm always reminded that, you know, when I'm running around from place to place, and I come to a place and I see how people are living in a close community.
Mr. Fritz Hoffmann, thank you very much. We were pleasured to have you here.
It's been really such a wonderful joy.
Thank you very much.